and welcome. You're watching Tip TV Finance with me, Jenny Hammond and Zach Mir. So Zach, before we go move on to the slides, let's start with the biggest story in the FT today, which is SoftBank selling $8 billion worth of shares of Arm to a Saudi investment trust. That, of course, is the UK's biggest tech company. So what are you feeling about that?
I thought you were going to talk about International Women's Day, but obviously not. I thought at the time that SoftBank paid too much for Arm. Arm was always on a very high rating. So in a way, selling 25% averages down in terms of the cost they paid. And I suppose that's about, it's almost inevitable, I think.
Do you think so? Okay, so let's move on to our first story of the day. In Saudi Arabia, Russia offer united front on oil production cuts. That's according to Bloomberg. What do you think's going on there, Zach?
I think it's all about Russia, actually, for me. Really, until Russia became the big player in the OPEC, non-OPEC game, they couldn't arrange a drinks party in a brewery. But since they've turned up, whatever is said, whatever OPEC said says it's going to do actually happens, which is unbelievable for the market. I think it's the last time OPEC has had any credibility in that way since 1973. So it really is a big change and probably the new normal as far as the oil market is concerned.
Okay. Next slide. So HP Enterprise to pay $1 billion for Nimble storage firm. That's according to the Irish Examiner. A good price there, Zach?
I'm sure it is. Unfortunately, I have absolutely no knowledge of who Nimble are. I thought they were a type of bread, so I can't help at all. But I'm sure that it was a good deal.
Okay, next slide. Okay, so data out overnight show that China's imports ballooned 44.7% in February, while exports rose just 4.2%. So that a sudden 6.4 billion yuan black hole opened up. The first trade deficit since February 2014. It's probably linked to the Lunar New Year holiday.
Well, what a story. I suppose 60 billion yuan isn't not that much in the scheme of things if you're China, so that probably explains part of it, and the other part, obviously, the timing of the holiday. But, China, it's one of those things, it is too big to fail. There can't be a bubble bursting there. We have to hope that the command economy is being steered in the right direction.
Despite all its bad debt, you still think it's too big to fail?
We don't want China to fail because it obviously would be disastrous and the knock-on effects for the rest of the world economy.
Oh, quite. Okay, so today is International Women's Day, as you said just before, and with a hashtag of Be Bold for Change and slogans including Take Action and Celebrate, as clearly you're doing today, Zach. So, yeah, right, I shan't be holding my breath. Interest here that ex-heavyweight Michael Heseltine, 83, was sacked by Prime Minister Theresa May as a government advisor for voting against her party in the Lords on Tuesday. So what do you make of all that?
Delighted that Michael Heseltine was sacked. I'm not quite sure why he became such a pro-European. It seems to be the thing for old Tories to do.
Actually calling for another referendum, but now people are saying that maybe there should be a referendum about getting rid of the House of Lords.
I think that's absolutely right. It's actually all this fiasco is all the fault of the High Court and the Supreme Court. I think they're the people who've actually put Parliament in a very embarrassing situation, but both in the House of Commons and the House of Lords. If there hadn't been that referral back to Parliament, and they were trying to delay it anyway, the Supreme Court and the High Court, we wouldn't be in this fiasco. But good that Mr. Heseltine has been sacked, and maybe he can retire now. The other thing there is that these slogans, Be Bold for Change and Take Action and Celebrate, what does that mean? Yeah. It really is quite inane. I think women need to do more than just
it's like the tampon adverts. They're a bit patronising, really, aren't they?
So, they are actually just the type of patronising thing women don't need.
Yeah, exactly. So. Okay, but still, International Women's Day, let's note it. Okay, so the economic calendar. We've obviously got the budget out today here in the UK, so we'll have to see what happens there and talk about it tomorrow. But in the US, we've got the ADP employment change in US crude oil inventories, and then foreign investment in Japan stocks. Anything there that you think is really important to note?
The ADP employment change is normally a front runner for what will come through in the non-farm payrolls tomorrow. But in the recent past, it's just been around the 180 average, 180,000 average on the payroll. So I suppose it'll be wage growth that people will be looking at.
Okay, super. Next slide. So FX sentiment, Zach, what are you seeing?
The big change is they're going more short of the Aussie dollar, which so far this morning has been correct. It's fallen from around 76 to 75.60, so a reasonable push down there. On the euro as well, going more negative, but the euro has really been in a 105, 106 range. It looks like 105 is solid unless Marine Le Pen looks like she might win. So at the moment we're holding, it's a buy on dips.
Okay, and the next slide, we've got the trade of the day.
Yeah, very, very strong rally for HSBC over recent months. Not surprising given that it's a big dividend payer, and also in the wake of the Donald Trump election and hopes of banking deregulation. Maybe there's a bit in this trade, sell around 665, objective 620, but I would be surprised if the shares fell more than that, just because of that strong dividend that it pays out.
Okay, and moving on to market vectors, gold.
Yes, gold here, a big problem for gold bulls in the last few weeks, where we've actually had the surprise that the Fed is almost certain to raise rates next week. That wasn't really in the script, and rising interest rates obviously not good for gold. So this is a definite warning here on the technical side.
So this goes against one of our guests saying that March is the month to buy gold. Are you going to do it?
It may be after the dip has been finished, maybe after the Fed act next week, maybe it could be.
Next slide. So this is the S&P 500.
Looking a bit overstretched for me, that last gap on that chart, it could be an exhaustion feature. And as you can see, you wouldn't really want to pay more. I mean, you would want to buy this on dips towards that red line, the 20 period exponential moving average, which is currently around 2350. So maybe wait for a dip towards that level, as that slide suggests.
And last slide is broker recommendations.
Yeah, Just Eat, a company that I'm obsessed by. We've got overweight there. I think the company this week announced profits up 163%. So it's actually been as good on a fundamental basis as I'd hoped for. And the brokers are remaining bullish on it. The other interesting thing of the day is Barclays Capital have initiated coverage on the three main drugs companies, Shire, Astra and Glaxo. Maybe you should check that out. I think the current target there of £65 on Shire, £15 above the current share price level. And then finally, Macri going for outperform on Tesco. No target there, but at least it's a feeling of a goodwill towards the grocer there.
Super, Zach. Thank you. Well, coming up next, our proactive investor shares the day.
Welcome to the Proactive Investors Bulletin Board, where we're looking at Europa oil and gas. Recent news flow, basically City analyst blast council decision to block Russell Field development, Europa oil and gas deals Angus Energy into Holmwood project in the Weald Basin. And the latest news today, $6 million farm out to Cairn Energy. Looking at the daily chart, you can see that basically investors have been on the front foot here in terms of the price action since the beginning of last year, rising trend channel on the daily chart since April. Solid support towards the floor of the channel and the 200-day moving average at 4.65 pence ahead of the latest gap to the upside through the 50-day line at 5.05. That's normally a decent buy signal, the gap through the 50-day line. Target at the moment, while we're above the 4.5 pence zone, as high as 8 pence, the top of last year's trend channel.